I'm Etienne Demarly. I'm fifth year PhD student in the NSC department. I come from France and I've always been interested in science, and so during my studies I specialized in electrical engineering and computer science, and eventually throughout my master's study I specialized into nuclear engineering in France. Through that path I was able to get in MIT through an internship back in 2012, and that's where I came here and I discovered the field of thermal hydraulics, the simulations, the numerical simulations that we do here. So what I'm working on is a phenomenon called DNB, called departure from nucleate boiling. And that's very important for the limiting powers of nuclear reactors, especially. And there is a limiting phenomenon that occurs during boiling if you generate so much heat that you have a huge amount of steam generated at the surface. That steam can kind of clog up next to the surface and act as a kind of an insulator layer. And when there's this transition where you used to be able to remove a lot of heat by boiling, and suddenly that layer of steam isolates the surface, there is a big jump in the surface temperature of your fuel elements. And that can lead to accidents and like melting of the fuel and things like that. And what I'm doing is creating models to try to predict this, this phenomenon. The phenomenon has been identified, we know it happens. The limits is our capabilities to predict it. And so far, because we're not very good at it, we have to add a ton of safety margins in the nuclear reactor power, basically. And so if we're able to reduce the uncertainties in our prediction models, we can reduce the margins and operate either safely or operate at higher powers for nuclear reactors. So that's why it's important. What's exciting is all the aspect of building a model, understanding all the pieces, the physics. There's like a lot of moving parts that have to come together in order to make something that acts physically. And so every time we try something, there's something that necessarily doesn't work very well, and we have to understand where it's coming from, which piece of the model is actually breaking down, and try to fix them one by one. Here is very research oriented, and I would like to be a little bit more into the development side of those techniques I'm developing. So we know that the industry is using those methods and those techniques that I'm working with here, but I would like to be a little bit more involved into the industry aspect of it. I discovered CUDO through MIT. A year and a half ago, I just went out of curiosity, and I've been practicing ever since. It's really nice. It's just traditional Japanese archery. I think it's like an anchor point for me. It's like every week I go there. It's like quite different in many ways than regular modern Western archery. It's a bit less focused on performance and accuracy, and a bit more on meditation, on like introspections.